Now, already some people are already in that doze mode that you're going to wake up in about 10 minutes because it gets exciting once again. But you say, well, what does this story of 3,000 years ago have to do with my life today? First of all, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego chose death over worshiping idols. You see, all they had to do was bend a knee to worship the golden idols. You say, well, see, that doesn't apply to me. Oh, yes, it does. People of God, we are perhaps today, and I'm going to speak candidly and forthrightly, I only get to celebrate 15 years one time. We're more guilty of idol worship in our lives today than perhaps any other time in church history, particularly in America. You say, well, I don't have a golden image set up. No, but you've probably got someone talking to you through an electronic tube 24 hours a day, or at least 8 hours a day. Or you've got something that you can turn on and listen to, or you've got the internet to go to. You see, there are a lot of things that distract us, and yet how much time do we spend focused upon our relationship with God? Because anything that takes you away from your relationship with God is an idol. Now again, I'm not trying to be a fanatic, I'm just trying to bring life to you, to recognize the fact that one day we're going to stand before the one who gave us life, who created our lives, and he's going to say, what did you do with your life? Well, and that's going to be our accountability. And you're not going to say, well, I worshiped at this idol and I worshiped at this idol, but even the good things sometimes become idols in our life. If they take you away from your focus on God, upon the knowing that God loves you. I'm not talking about the judgmental God. I'm not talking about the God of the Ten Commandments. I'm talking about a God of grace who loves you, gave his life for you, wants a relationship with you, has forgiven you. By his shed blood, himself came to the table and said, come, let us reason together, says the Lord. But he doesn't force us. He says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in, but I won't barge in. I won't force myself upon your life. But I stand ready to come in. If you'll simply open the door, if you'll embrace me, I will embrace you. I will come in. I will sup with you and you with me. And that's an eternal relationship that we can have with the living God.